There we are at parking lot number 4, the Venerable. Parking lot number 4, here in the core of the Parker River National Wildlife Refuge, selected by none other than Rachel Carson herself. It's a duck heaven. Off in the distance to the back, there's the small hills of Newbury and Rowley. You can see the system of dikes made to harvest salt hay. Down there, we're looking towards Ipswich and Cranes. Looks to the north. All right, more or less horizontal. And it's the Hellcat Swamp parking lot and the entrance area. And here we are about to impose ourselves on the venerable Hellcat Trail boardwalk. This place will really be nuts in May, what with all the mixed flock warbler invasions. We've already noticed that Plum Island is still in trouble. Significant parts of access are closed off, not for plover nesting, but because the human nests are falling into the drink, and they're still in a state of denial about this. Here we are at the fork. We'll try the marsh loop and then examine the dune loop. Well, yellow's new. There's an interpretive trail point keyed to a map thing. I wonder if they'll have apps for them. And a loop within a loop. What have we here? Ah, yes. This will come in a full circle. This brings you into the heart of the phragmite jungle. the sort of place where you're most likely to run into such things as bitterns, and rails, and other secretive marsh critters. This thing's been here forever. There you see the place unfold from the perspective of the ground. Interpretive item number 4. The boardwalk will run this way. It's been around for quite a while. Thing in the 70s. And now we'll follow this ancient and venerable boardwalk back into the woodier sections. There's even a little bog around here somewhere with actual sphagnum. Planty and bug-eating plant thing, whatnot. I believe it's over in here somewhere. And I believe we'll be able to actually get to the shore. My new theory about the lower section, or actually up near the entrance. They're all of the accesses are blocked off. I think it's they're trying to create a buffer zone to discourage you from getting near the various moron homes that tumbled into the beach. For the hubris of others shall we suffer. Wow. Ooh, this one's decorated. My, whatever is this? All right. Big swamp maple budding. I remember this. This is an old, cool observation blind. Hear the pounding surf off in the distance. Oh, interesting. Yeah, they probably love this place. So the other advantages. This is before the mosquitoes have hatched. They're like nature's Viet Cong. And then, of course, there's black fly season. But you know what black fly season means? It's they're an indicator of water purity. They can only hatch in streams with lots of oxygen, so they could go together with trout. So this is the comfort you can derive when they're biting the crap out of you in May and becoming a garnish in your ham and cheese sandwich mixed in there with the mustard. Oh, the actual blind part's kind of gone. There used to be one. right here, maybe they concluded that it was useless.